A very hearty good evening, everyone. I, Anjali Singh, welcome you all to this induction program 2017-19. Respected Bala sir, on and off dais dignitaries, and all the aspiring student managers. Today we have amongst us very inspiring and efficacious Mr. Rajat Sarkar, who holds a degree of MBA in marketing. Rajat sir has a combat of 18 years in the field of advertising. Rajat sir joined Paradigm Plus at the age of 25 and is currently designated as a director at Paradigm Plus Mktg Communications Private Limited, a leading advertising agency in Pune with offices in Mumbai and Bangalore. Stay positive is his mantra for life. In the final year of graduation, he was bitten by the bug of the super blessed profession of advertising, and that's when he decided to do his MBA. After his MBA in 1997, Rajat sir joined Johnson & Nicholson, a Calcutta-based paints major, and then headed the franchisee operations in Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh for a computer education major, Aptech. In year 1999, Rajat sir joined a young advertising agency, Paradigm Plus, which was founded by Ashika Sarkar. Pune has seen Paradigm Plus evolve from a startup to a company with a large team of 65 plus professionals. His clients are major brands like Wipro, Reliance Footprint, Scania Trucks and Buses, Govind's Milk and Milk Products, RIO, and many more. Rajat sir has won many national awards in the field of advertising, like the Abbey Award and that too gold. Now I would request sir to shower his experience and knowledge to all our student managers. Sir, the floor is all yours.
Good evening, friends. My name is Rajat. Let's be more specific. Sir is there. So, thoda aadat nahi hai na sir sunne ka. We are in that kind of a profession where we are largely addressing each other by first names. So you guys can call me Rajat. Thanks for this opportunity. Let me thank Rajiv is not here. Rajiv Mitra is the MD of Govind, who requested me to do this session. Thanks to Asha ma'am, she's also not there. So friends, I was told to... Okay. But I have to operate it there. Yeah, cool. So I was supposed to talk about how to make a good ad, right? That's the topic given to me. Rather, how to make an ad. So guys, I think people, all of you, I mean, can I ask a very small question to anybody? Anybody can answer this, even if you don't have a mic. What do you guys think is the core of an ad? Anybody? What is it, the soul of any advertisement? Product, beautiful. Idea. What message you want to deliver? Creativity, yes? Punchlines, part of creativity. Okay, so let me gather 3-4 keywords. You guys said product, very, very important. No product, no business, no need of advertising. Creativity, the core message, the content. Product? Product image, so beautiful photograph. Okay. Emotional connect, beautiful. Who said that? What are the three benefits of your product? Okay. nice. Very nice. So, Bala sir, you don't have to worry. Aadha kaam ho chuka hai aapka. The kids are half ready. But trust me, the rest half is what the challenge is. So friends, what I'm going to show you today is what at Paradigm Plus we follow. People at Paradigm Plus come from, am I audible? People from Paradigm Plus come from national agencies like Ogilvy & Mather, Lintas, TBWA, Saatchi & Saatchi, which is formed after a JV with a big agency called Law & Kenneth. It is now called Law & Kenneth, Saatchi & Saatchi. All of these guys, what they have brought on the table in so many years, in the last 18 years, are processes. whatever you guys said, barring a product which is none of my business, a product is something that the client gives me, whatever rest you guys talked about, it has to go through a process. Whatever you guys spoke, each and every component in advertising is important, or in an ad is important. And these components, what you guys talked about, make the departments or the divisions in an agency. So somebody talked about the core message that has to be given, part of strategy. Somebody said creative, so the creative guys. Somebody talked about the representation of the product, so photography. Whatever words you guys spoke, those words make departments or divisions in an agency. Just like any other industry, I feel our industry has also evolved a lot. There was a time when creative was the key. Even today, creatives are very, very important. But friends, trust me, today advertising has become extremely business-oriented. Extremely business-oriented. When I say business-oriented, if my creative does not achieve a particular business goal or a marketing challenge of the brand, I cease to exist. I have no reason to exist. There is a continuous war that you guys can see on different channels, on the digital medium, which is happening between an agency and a client, where an agency would insist that a particular creative will get him the results, and the client would insist that, in a yes or no, a client would insist that, yes, this will work or this will not work. And this war is important. This debate is important. This has to go on and on and on, because when it comes to a client, nobody understands his product and his business better than him. And when it comes to communication, so if I'm going a little broad, from advertising I'm moving to marketing communication. So when it comes to marketing communication, nobody understands this better than our community, the advertising agency's community. When it's action in cohesion, when both the teams work together, you will see fantastic results. And when they are not, of course, the results are not so great. So we'll not get into that premise. What we will come to is, thus, the process becomes more important. So as I will take you through a few slides, I will concentrate on the process. And if we can follow this process, what are the results? Yeah? But remember that word which I told you, friends, that our business is getting more and more business-oriented. So when you guys will graduate after 2 years from this institution, just keep that in mind, that it's business first, it's marketing first, creativity later. So yeah, we are 18 years old. This is how the structure goes largely. So you'd see an account planning team there, which is the core that we follow. Now, there are agencies in India which are very focused and aligned towards creatives. There are agencies in India which are very, very focused on strategy. So an agency like, you guys have heard of Ogilvy and Mather? Lintas, yeah. So Ogilvy is a very, very creative-oriented agency. Lintas is more towards strategy first. So on those lines, Paradigm Plus is a very strategy-oriented agency. Now this is by choice. There is no rule that you have to be creative-oriented or you have to be strategy-oriented. This is purely by choice. We, by choice, are strategy-oriented. So until we answer why we are doing what we are doing, we do not enter the creative department. Very, very important. I'll come to a very important slide which we follow at Paradigm Plus. I'll not go very deep into it. So there is an 8-step process that we follow, very simple 8-step process, where we try to understand the market insight. The word insight here, friends, is very, very important. And you will read many articles on advertising where insight is becoming extremely important. So while I take you guys through these 8 steps, let me also simultaneously discuss a case with you guys. How important is insight? Anybody can tell me not the current campaign, but the campaign which has been going on for Cadbury's maybe in the last 6 months? I heard something. Louder? Kuch meetha ho jaye. The alien one is the current one. Yeah, I have no understanding why. It's an imported ad, huh, friends. It's an imported ad. They have picked it up and they are doing it for India. Meetha ho jaye is a premise where Cadbury's got into in the last 4 years. Any idea why? Okay, what was it before Meetha Ho Jaye? 4 saal pehle, kuch campaigns yaad hai? Huh? Re, aaj pehli tarikh is a part of kuch Meetha Ho Jaye. Pappu Pass Ho Gaya is a part of kuch Meetha Ho Jaye. Before kuch Meetha Ho Jaye. Kuch khaas hai, somebody. Somebody said kuch khaas. Oh, you said. Okay. So, kuch khaas hai zindagi mein. The girl in the cricket stadium. Her boyfriend hit a six. Remember? So, guys, the every word in advertising very clearly has an objective. So, when it said kuch khaas hai zindagi mein, it's only special occasions when chocolate was consumed, right? Right? Dhanda kam tha. Dhanda kam tha. Because Cadbury's is very clearly saying that you consume chocolates only in khas occasion, special occasion. Itne nahi hote apne life mein special occasion. Ya kam badh rahe the special occasion. In spite of having, I think we have a festival every month. Right from Nag Panchami to Diwali. Lekin, I think Cadbury's agenda would be ki bas Nag Panchami ke din bhi Cadbury consume karo. So be it. So be it. That's what, that was the reason why Cadbury's had to look at an entire change of positioning as far as the brand was concerned when they moved from kuch khaas hai zindagi mein to kuch meetha ho jaye. So friends, here's a little tip or insight as to how did they arrive at that. So let's say 4 or 5 years back, market share, you guys understand? I mean, I know it's a first class, but market share is a very simple word, any brand in its category, what kind of, right? Revenue-wise, what market share they're holding. Every brand, every CEO of a company is extremely conscious about this terminology called market share. It's difficult for a CEO to come up with this premise and not think market share. But Cadbury's did. And they had to do it because had they not come out of this premise of market share to revenues, their revenues would continue to dip. I hope I'm making sense to you guys. Yeah? What is important for a company? Market share or revenues? Any day. My revenues have to grow continuously. Market share can keep going up and down. Do you guys realize in the last 4 to 5 years, what is the kind of competition has cropped up in chocolate market? Lindt's of the world in the top category. We can afford imported chocolates, so the number of brands have emerged like crazy. On the lower rung, you have an Amul, which is much, much cheaper. For a kid who can't afford a chocolate, Amul is the first chocolate. Thus, Cadbury now had to make a 10 rupee pack, a 5 rupee pack, ki 5 rupee mein chocolate khareed sakte ho. Everything has got a business objective. Anyways, coming back to the story of why they had to enter the premise of kuch meetha ho jaye. Guys, any idea what is the chocolate market of India? Anybody? Forget it. Let's say 1,000 crores. 1,000 crores. What do you guys think if I assume that the chocolate market of India is 1,000 crores, what do you guys think would be the mithai market of India? Mithai market, huh? Rasgulla, peda, sab pakad lo, Mysore Pak. Wild guess, 10 times, 20 times, 30 times? Minimum 10 times? Great. So here's a statement. Let's say the Cadbury brand was a 65 to 70% market shareholder of the 1,000 crore chocolate market of India. I repeat, I am a market leader. I am a 65 to 70% market shareholder of the 1,000 crore chocolate market of India. Because I am calling myself a chocolate. Now the board decides that can I redefine my business? Can I call myself a sweet? It's a big insight. The moment I say I am a sweet, from a 65% market shareholder of the 1,000 crore chocolate market of India, I become a 6.5% market shareholder of the 10,000 crore mithai market of India. I'll repeat my statement. From a 65% market shareholder of the 1,000 crore chocolate market of India, overnight I become a 6.5% market shareholder of the 10,000 crore mithai market, sweet market of India. To hell with market share. It's okay if overnight I have become from 65%, I've become a 6.5%. But the magic is, in that 10,000 crore mithai market of India, if I grow by 1% annually, I grow by 100 crore annually. Wow. Thus, the campaign, kuch meetha ho jaye. Now, Pappu pass ho gaya, kuch meetha ho jaye. Aaj pehli tarikh hai, kuch meetha ho jaye. This guy marrying learn on this girl, you know, and bandstand. Maa kehti hai, kuch shubh kaam karne se pehle kuch meetha kha lena chahiye. Everything lands at kuch meetha ho jaye. A brand trying to convince this country that please don't look at me as a chocolate anymore. I am a sweet. This was the business objective, and thus, this is the campaign. Of course, done by the industry genius, Mr. Anybody knows who did the campaign? Kuch meetha ho jaye done by? Oh, Amitabh Bachchan is... who is the guy? Who is the advertising guy behind it? Piyush Pandey, brilliant. Ogilvy and Mather. So friends, this story was a little insight for you guys. To understand that advertising, if you guys think that advertising is creative, yes, it is. It better be. If you're not creative, you have no business to be in advertising. But in today's scenario, if your creativity does not meet my business objective, I don't need you. So until and unless you guys understand the business objective of the brand or the marketing challenge of the brand, you don't know in what direction to think. This is very, very important. In what direction to think. In our industry, this is what is called as a brief. Yeah? Jo shirt ke andar pehante wala nahi hai, bhai. Brief is a document in which the strategy team is handing over this document to the creative team, setting a clear direction to them. Setting a clear direction to them that this is the direction you will think. In that document, the business objective or the marketing challenge is clearly mentioned, and what we have to achieve is also clearly mentioned, so that the creative department in turn gets clarity. Gets clarity. I hope by now you guys realize that our business is more scientific. It is. And it is becoming more scientific. Big data is playing a big role. There's a lot of research that happens, and until we have clear information from this research, or you call it big data or whatever, the creative department does not start its work because the directions are not set. So whatever we'll see today will be on this platform. So these 8 steps is a small process that we follow. Different agencies have different models. This is our model. So it starts with the market insight, trying to understand the market scenario, the current scenario of the market. Then we come to client insight, where we try to understand what is a client's legacy or history. Yeah? Agar Tata ki ad ban rahi hai, toh Tata ki legacy dikhni chahiye. That it's a national brand. Yeah? Tata namak, desh ka namak. And only that kind of a brand deserves it. Yeah? Category insight, trying to understand every product today has many categories. Where you break it down, if you look at automobiles today, two-wheelers have so many categories. There is this 100cc engine, 100 to 150cc, 150 to 200cc. Soaps and detergents have so many categories. For washing machines, haath se dhone ke liye, kapde ke liye alag category hai, washing machine alag category hai. Understanding that category better. Coming to step number 4, product insight, where I'm trying to understand what is so great about the product. Somebody here told product, very, very important, trying to understand what is so great in this product. Immediately trying to understand how my competitors' products are. Step 6 is a very interesting step, consumer insight. One of my personal favorites. Anybody can think about the iPhone campaign 4 months back? The current campaign is a red phone on a red surface, but the iPhone campaign 4 months back? Little louder. iPhone 7 campaign, the iPhone 7 was launched. Come again? Camera, on the camera part. What is the line? What is the line? There's a huge, beautiful photograph shown on the hoarding, and there's a small line. Shot on an iPhone 7. Brilliant. What was the campaign on iPhone 6 almost a year back? Same, shot on an iPhone 6. See, that shot on an iPhone 6, if you guys have noticed, was largely showing sexy images. iPhone 7 was showing images shot in the dark. Because iPhone 7 had that camera which can shoot fantastic photographs within a discotheque, or if the sun is setting, where there is not much of light, it can shoot fantastic photograph. Can you imagine, guys, kahan se ye premise mein pahunche ye log? Main phone bech raha hu, camera bech raha hu, yaar. Kuch to phone ke baare mein baat karo. And look at the brands. Look at the brands like a Vivo and Oppo. I mean, you guys would all use, I mean, selfie expert camera and koi phone ki baat nahi kar raha hai. I can literally recall the Dio era where they used to say, you know, ye Dio lagao, ladki paas aayegi. And everybody followed suit. दसवें ब्रांड को समझ में नहीं आया मैं क्या बोलूं, उसने बोला चल यार यही बोल देते हैं, कम से कम पब्लिक को कंफ्यूजन होगा, कुछ ना कुछ तो मेरा ही ब्रांड उठा लेंगे मार्केट से. अंटिल आई कांट रिकॉल, आई मीन रितेश, व्हिच ब्रांड लेटली इज टॉकिंग अबाउट कि किसने बोला है कि लड़की पास आएगी. इरफान खान का एड है, वेयर दैट ब्रांड इज ट्राइंग टू ब्रेक द होल नोशन कि बकवास है ये सब, ऐसा नहीं होता है. I'm waiting for some mobile brand which will break this whole premise of camera and camera. Somebody would come up with some other communication direction. Everybody is running after camera. But guys, the big question is, why? Absolutely. I mean, the consumer said very clearly, I mean, if iPhone 1 year back went to 100 iPhone users and asked them, what is the sexiest feature in my phone? And the 95 out of 100 guys says, you know what? I mean, the photographs that a camera clicks is like amazing. It's pure insight. The brand picked up the insight. And can you guys even imagine what kind of money is the brand invested on that single insight? 100 crores? 200 crores? I think iPhone invested more than 1,000 crores on that single idea that shot on an iPhone 6. And because it was a huge success for iPhone 6, iPhone 7 followed suit. That shot on an iPhone 7, dark photographs. What I'm coming to, guys, is advertising today, I don't know what will be the future of advertising, I'm no fortune teller, but advertising today is extremely insight-based. And that insight must take care of the marketing challenge, adding to the revenues of the client. And while we do all this, if we get an award, wow. But this is one situation that is going to remain for long, because CEOs of brands, CEOs of companies, they are extremely tight on a word called ROI. Itna nahi tha hamare industry mein ye pehle, but ab bahut zyada hai. For every money spent, for every penny spent, they are asking, what was the return? Ab idea ke upar return dikhana bahut mushkil hai. Bahut mushkil hai. But yes, there are tools that even measure that. Going to September 7, brand insight. Very, very important again. What is the role of a brand in the life of a consumer? I'm sure you guys understand that, oh, ek bahut acha joke bhi hai, no? Haath mein iPhone pakda hua acha lagta hai, papa, isliye iPhone dila do. And the baap says, pakda hua to tu bhi achha hi lagta tha. Thodi na tere ko humne chhod diya. But it matters, guys. It does matter. What watch you wear, what shoes we wear. Very, very important. So that's brand insight. And of course, at the end of it, we come to communication insight, where we try to understand how a brand has been communicating till now. All this makes a planning brief. And once the planning brief is approved by the client and the agency, it goes to the creative team. Little heavy for all of you? I mean, all of you are first year students, right? Yeah, little heavy. But trust me, guys, as you will go through your 2 years, yeah, you will get to see a lot of ads. My request is, next time when you see an ad on your phone, on television, on a print, try to ask yourself what must have been the story behind the ad. There's always a story, huh? Always. Always a story. So try to understand what is the story behind that. Okay. I don't want to go this. Can I look at the next? I want to open the next presentation. Thanks. I'll start with my first case. Anybody remembers a few of the steps that I showed? You do? Great. So as I proceed, try to understand from which step that insight came. Okay? Heard of this brand called Piaggio? Scooter. Arey, advertising ka class chal raha hai. Brand ka naam lo yaar. Product ka nahi. Vespa, wow. And? Auto rickshaw brand ka naam thodi hai yaar. Ape, who said ape? Okay, aap come again. Yeah, yeah, here somebody said aap. Okay. Good. From which city you are? Kya dikhta hai wahan pe? Aap ka? Pickup tempo or a passenger tempo. Or us passenger tempo mein kitne log baithe hue dekhe aapne? Good observation. Good power. Okay. Good. So this brand, Piaggio, is an Italian brand, has two divisions. In our language, we call it commercial vehicle, what you said, the luggage one. And the other division is a two-wheeler division. For a few of you guys who are interested in two-wheelers, there is a brand called Aprilia, a very high-end bike, starts at some 20, 25 lakhs. That's a part of the two-wheeler division. And of course, the iconic brand, Vespa. Vise, aap logo ko yaad hai, Vespa bahut pehle bhi hua karta tha? LML Vespa. So the same Vespa, it's the same Vespa. So because of whatever reasons, they went off the country and they are now back. We handle the commercial vehicle division of this brand. So friends, a little story as to, see the agenda of today's session is how do you make an ad? So maybe in the next 2 years, you will get to see many interesting ads, which you can see on your television also. What I'm trying to explain to you guys is what goes behind an ad. And I know only one way of doing it, that is the insight part of it. And until you get the right insight, the right communication does not come out. Hamare industry mein isko bolte hai, effective communication. Communication that will make sense to your consumer and will help your product move. So, this slide is very, very important. Rest is for us. So guys, हमारे लिए बड़ा डिफिकल्ट था. इट वॉज वेरी वेरी चैलेंजिंग बिकॉज इन आर फ्रेंड सर्कल वी डू नॉट नो पीपल हु आर रिक्शा ड्राइवर्स. हैड पीपल टोल्ड अस अबाउट कार परचेजर्स, आई कैन गो टू 10 फ्रेंड्स ऑफ माइन, आई कैन टॉक टू पीपल लाइक यू हु बाय और हुज फादर्स आर बाइंग कार्स एंड ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द सेंसिबिलिटीज बिहाइंड बाइंग अ कार. विथ रिक्शा गाइज आई हैड नो चॉइस. We had to sit, the team had to sit in dhabas, in rickshaw stands, because that's where information is being shared. If you guys think that, yes, the insights will come in air-conditioned offices, some do, but many don't. Your insights are lying out there in the market with the consumer. When you sit with them, when you talk to them, you will get your insights. So we got two beautiful insights. Step number 6, consumer insight. That's where we got one beautiful insight. When we were speaking to these guys and they said that, do you guys realize how the society is abusing us? And we were surprised. I said, wow, I mean, you're talking of saying a big word, friend, abusing. He said, yeah. Meri kadar nahi hai society mein. said, okay. क्यों नहीं है भाई? We have to delve a little deep. कि क्यों नहीं आप ऐसा क्यों बोलते हो कि I hate my job, I hate my profession? He said, आप बताओ कि जो माल के लिए 1,000 रुपए मिलना चाहिए to take it from point A to point B, मुझे आदमी 500 रुपए देता है? कोई मुझे एक बूंद पानी भी नहीं पूछता है? I think all of you who come from metro cities would realize that a rickshaw wala seldom would put his meter on. He would always ask for a blanket money, 50 रुपए, 100 रुपए. गुस्सा आता है ना हम लोगों को? किस बात के 100 रुपए? जब ओला और उबर आपसे वही शाम के 7 बजे 1.7 टाइम्स एक्स करके ले लेता है, तब हमें गुस्सा नहीं आता? नहीं आता ना? आता है? I'm sure आप लोग, आधे लोग तो ओला उबर यूज करते होंगे इधर, है ना? सेफ, कन्वीनियंट, एंड वी आर रेडी टू पे फॉर इट. देयर इज नो ऑप्शन, एंड यू आर रेडी टू पे फॉर इट बिकॉज इट कम्स इन राइटिंग टू यू, राइट? So when you click on a Ola or a Uber, they respond 1.5 times X. You guys agree to it, right? You press the agree button and then the cab is booked. The rickshawala does not have it. But the passenger rickshawala is trying to tell us as a society that it's not feasible for me to make you travel from point A to point B in 20 bucks. I don't care about the government meter. It's not feasible for me. You pay me 50 bucks. Or I don't move. And we think that the guy does not deserve our business. He's arrogant. Well, that is another part of him where he feels that he is left out of the society. Now, this is a beautiful insight. So, one insight very clearly that I hate my job, I hate my profession. He's a poor chap. He's a 10th plus, 12th plus guy. I have to understand him. I have to understand his sensibilities. We always thought that this is one community of people. ये लोग दिन में शायद से 500, 700, 1000 रुपए कमाते होंगे और शाम को दारू और जुए में उड़ा देते होंगे. We were wrong. We were absolutely wrong. You, all of you guys who come from a city like Bangalore or I don't know, Delhi इतना इस्तेमाल होता है क्या? Every rickshaw wala in Bangalore or Chennai carries his mobile phone. He is a Ola rig guy. He is digital savvy. Ask him his qualification. Maybe he's not even a 10th or 12th pass. He's evolved, but he's clear about one thing. His child will not do or take over his profession. Beautiful insight for us. Insight number two. If I take this vehicle off the road, because he is saying, aap log ko meri zarurat nahi hai. If I take this vehicle off the road, what will happen? Unemployment. What else? Inconvenience. What else? Come again? Yeah, absolutely. Monopoly situations where a brand will like make huge amount of money. That's for passenger. Any idea what will happen to cargo if I take these vehicles off? Come again? So guys, look at the current transportation system of this country, the logistics of the country. The bigger trucks today cannot enter the cities. They're not allowed. For all of you who know Mumbai a little, parts of Mumbai allows trucks to enter between 5 a.m. and like 1 a.m. to 5 a.m. is where the bigger trucks can enter the city. So the trucks will leave the goods outside the city. From there are these little bigger tempos which will get it like another 5 kilometers inside to the godowns. But from the godowns to a distributor, to a dealer, to a retailer, and many a times to our places, who are getting these goods? Who are traveling the last mile? Who's traveling the last mile? Who's traveling the goods in the last mile? These small pickup vehicles. In the three-wheeler category, this brand. In the four-wheeler category, you guys must have seen this brand called Tata Ace. Also called as Chota Hathi, colloquially. That's what advertising has given the name to that brand. If I take these vehicles off the road, my entire transportation system, the logistics system, will collapse. So, classic situation. My consumer, who is the driver and the owner of this vehicle, thinks that he is not required in the society. The truth is, I cannot do without him. He is indispensable for me. How do I communicate this classic situation to this guy who is just a 10th and 12th pass? Very difficult, guys. The less educated your crowd is, your target audience is. Target audience is the people you speak to. The bigger is the challenge. The bigger is the challenge, because you have to keep your communication to the point, and you have to keep your communication simple that he understands it. Now, this is the brief that went to the creative team. And how the creative team now starts breaking this brief? The creative team says, okay, my consumer feels that he is not required. The fact is, I cannot do without him. My challenge is, how do I communicate this message? How do I give this message that you guys are indispensable for us to this 10th plus, 12th plus guy? So, jab aape chalta hai, to kya hota hai? Is where the whole drama started. Ki we got into very, very basic premise ki jab aape chalta hai, to kya hota hai? Jab aape chalta hai, to desh ka jo saman hai, the goods of this country, they move from point A to point B. Jab aape chalta hai, desh ka saman point A se point B jata hai. Jab aape chalta hai, to desh ka passenger point A se point B jata hai. So jab aape chalta hai, to desh ka saman chalta hai. Jab aape chalta hai, to desh ka passenger chalta hai. Jab aape chalta hai, to desh chalta hai. And this was that one statement where we got locked and came the creative. Aape chalta hai, to desh chalta hai. Guys, I repeat, I'm telling you the process of how do brands and agencies arrive at a particular creative. It's extremely scientific today. Har ek shabd ka, every word has a meaning and a place in the communication. Now, during my 8-step process, or when I was searching for the insight, I had this big thing bothering me, that this consumer saying that I don't think society needs me. And when we delved deep, he had said, the society does not treat me well. I wanted to tell him that, boss, tum saman leke nahi jaate ho. Tum desh ki economy leke jaate ho apne piche. The image that you are seeing is shot. I mean, I don't know if there are anybody from Hyderabad. This is Chudi Bazaar behind Charminar. But forget where it has been shot. This, Hindi mein isko Khudra Bazaar bolte hain. For those of you who come from northern part of India, this is called the Khudra Bazaar. And this is something that you will find in a Delhi, in a Bombay, in a Bangalore, in a Chennai, in any tier 1, tier 2, 3 city, or tier 3 city in this country. And huge economy of our country, guys. It's not the malls alone that contribute to our economy. This kind of a market contributes big time to our economy. And I am an indispensable part of that economy of India. The second thing that happened is, when we arrived at this kind of a premises, to make it more effective and to give better returns to my client, I had talked about ROI, friends. ROI on creatives, this is where the ROI comes. When I take the premise of India, what's India for you guys today? What's India for you guys? Is the country alone? Kya hai India? Huh? Market hai. Or? Emotion hai. Yes? Cricket hai? Bilkul. Brand hai. Brand. Guys, today India is a brand. Narendra Modi is riding on it. He's riding on it. We also took a ride on it. Aape chalta hai, to desh chalta hai. And when you ride on brand India, what you do next is create a barrier for your competitors. My competitors in this field are, there's a brand of Mahindra called Mahindra Alpha Champion. There is a brand in Gujarat and Rajasthan called Atul, for those who come from Gujarat and Rajasthan. Very big brand. Bajaj is getting into it, by the way, big time. Bajaj has been wiped out in the cargo vehicle category by this brand, but Bajaj is coming back. So Bajaj is my competitor today. So friends, I create a barrier around my communication when I say, aape chalta hai, to desh chalta hai. Now, this kind of a communication you guys must not have seen in tier 1, tier 2 cities, because it's largely prevalent in tier 2, tier 3 cities. Any brands which have been riding on brand India and have created this barrier? Any brand you can think of? Kya bolta hai? What is the line? देश की मिट्टी, टाटा नमक, ब्रिलियंट. नो, अंबुजा सीमेंट इज विराट कॉम्प्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ. कोई तो हीरो होंडा बोलो. देश की धड़कन, अमूल, टेस्ट ऑफ इंडिया. इंडिया गेट ने तो नाम में इंडिया रख दिया, किस्सा ही खत्म. सो मेनी ऑफ देम. सो डू यू गाइज रियलाइज हाउ वी आर ट्राइंग टू क्रिएट दैट बैरियर? दीज आर कॉल्ड एंट्री बैरियर्स इन द माइंड ऑफ द कंज्यूमर. When I take this premise, when a brand like Hero Honda, when a brand like Tata Namak, when a brand like Kajaria takes the whole platform of brand India, I create a huge barrier in the mind of my consumer. Guys, today we are moving beyond market share and we are entering mind share. Today brands want the TG's mind share. If you are thinking about buying a motorcycle and your budget is 40,000 rupees, 100cc category, Hero is very clear, Hero Motocorp is very clear. I have to be the first brand to come into your mind. 80% mind share of a target audience's customer's mind, has been taken up by one brand. And then comes a TVS and then comes a Bajaj or any other brand. Long by Bajaj had done it with its scooters. हमारा बजाज, they done it long back. Now, let's come to what we call as the rational part of an ad. Fine, there's an emotional ad. People feel good about it. The client was like, wow, I'm moving into a very different zone of being the cargo vehicle of the country. But then, when we go and meet the consumer, उसके तीन basic सवाल होते हैं. Now, that is the truth of the Indian consumer. Whether he is buying a motorcycle or a Mercedes Benz, एक सवाल वो जरूर पूछेगा. कितना देती है? I know S class customers asking कितना देती है. Hero Honda वाला तो पूछेगा ही पूछेगा. देती कितना है बॉस? This guy, it's business for him. 100% he is going to ask. So I'll have to mention ज़्यादा mileage, सबसे ज़्यादा mileage. अब किसका ज़्यादा ज़्यादा है? पता नहीं भाई. मेरा ज़्यादा ज़्यादा है. महिंद्रा बोलेगा मेरा ज्यादा ज्यादा है, बजाज बोलेगा मेरा ज्यादा ज्यादा है. बट बोलना पड़ेगा. इट्स नॉट क्लीशे, इट इज अ मैंडेट. माय कंज्यूमर वांट्स टू हियर दैट द ब्रांड आई हैव बॉट व्हेन इट कम्स टू ऑटो गिव्स मी द हाईएस्ट माइलेज. सेकंड पॉइंट, सबसे कम चलाने का खर्च. इट्स कमर्शियल व्हीकल, आई हैव नॉट बॉट इट फॉर फन, इट मीन्स बिजनेस टू मी. द मेंटेनेंस हैज टू बी लोएस्ट. थर्ड, 14 लाख पीपल, Indians, we are fantastic followers. One guy succeeds, उसके पीछे सब लग जाते हैं. So 14 लाख गाड़ियां रस्ते पे हैं. That's the highest number by any brand. But naturally, the consumer is like, 14 लाख हैं यार, चलो हम भी खरीदते हैं, कोई हर्ज नहीं है. So these are the mandatories. Yeah, and that's the core communication. Friends, we did small visiting cards. Campaign तो हुआ ही. We made small visiting cards at the dealership level. For these auto rickshaw drivers who would come and give their vehicle for servicing, their visiting cards carried their name, and behind the card they had this image called "Aape chalta hai to desh chalta hai." Can you imagine the pride that guy had now? We are continuously working in that direction to instill more and more pride in my consumer that he is an important part as far as the economy is concerned. Wo saman nahi dhota, wo mere desh ki economy dhota hai. He's a very important part of my economy. I cannot do that. I cannot do without him. And that was my core agenda when advertising started. And because the direction was set very clear, this is the result that you get. Because Cadbury's had that agenda very clear, that I don't want to be seen as a chocolate anymore. I want to be seen as a sweet, because what is important for me today is revenues and not market share. Thus the campaign, kuch meetha ho jaye. Because iPhone did its 8-step process very correctly and arrived at that fact that forget the phone, man, chuck the phone. What's working in my phone is the camera. Let's highlight the camera. It created magic. So the process, guys, is extremely important. Aapne agar process follow kiya, to natija behtareen hi niklega. Now, there's another part of it, which we call as extending a particular communication. So going back to the Cadbury example, you guys must have realized that for every ad, you know, pappu pass ho gaya, meetha ho jaye, maa kehti hai kuch shubh kaam karne se pehle kuch meetha kha lena chahiye, meetha ho jaye, pehli tarikh, meetha ho jaye. Everything is landing at a particular premise. That is because the brand wants to push it. I mean, imagine, I just asked you guys and you guys, you know, fatak se you guys said kuch meetha ho jaye. इतना बड़ा जो आपको एड दिखाया उन्होंने 30 सेकंड 40 सेकंड का करोड़ों रुपए खर्च किए, डजंट इट मीन एनीथिंग? इट डज. बट फ्रेंड्स, टुडे देयर आर सो मेनी ब्रांड्स अराउंड अस, देयर आर सो मच ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन अराउंड अस. आई मीन, यू गाइस आर 24 आवर्स ऑन योर मोबाइल. आप क्या क्या याद रखोगे? हाउ मच विल यू रिमेंबर? व्हाट ऑल विल यू रिमेंबर? एंड ब्रांड्स आर इक्वली कॉन्शियस अबाउट इट, कि दे हैव टू गिव दैट वन, मेक दैट वन बिग स्टेटमेंट दैट यू विल टेक होम. एंड दैट वन बिग स्टेटमेंट फॉर कैडबरी वॉज, I am a sweet. Look at the kind of money they spend on celebration packs today during Dashera and Diwali. Crazy. The same thing we had to do. So when it came to our different sub-brands, so these are the sub-brands. This vehicle is called the cargo vehicle. The communication went, cargo jo desh chalai. This vehicle, I think you were talking about this in Jaipur, you will see a lot of it. This connects the fringe areas of a city to the entire rural belt. I have a photograph of this vehicle where it carries, where it's carrying 24 people and traveling between Noida and Greater Noida. Those of you who come from that belt of the country, sab rules toot jate hain wahan pe, kitne log baithe hain, jitne logo bithana hai bithao, 24 log baithe hue hain ek gaadi mein, and the vehicle is running. This is the latest addition in the list, which is competing with the market leader Bajaj Ari. Ab har city bolega aap pe chalta hai to desh chalta hai. So I am not leaving the premise of Desh across all three of my sub-brands, because that's the core message I want to give to my consumers. Boss, remember, I stand with this country. I don't stand with you, I stand with this country. And India is extremely emotional today. Huh? Extremely emotional. That ends this case. I will come to the next one. My next case is, I don't know if, For those of you who come from, it's a local brand, but it's growing very well. So I showed you one national brand, Piaggio. It's called Govind Milk and Milk Products. Anybody from Maharashtra, Pune? Oh, a lot of you. So you've heard of this brand? Anybody? You've heard? Wow, should feel good, man. Yeah, we have, you're one of your alumni here who is from Govind. So, fine. I mean, anybody, what will you associate Govind with? Ice cream. Yeah, any. Come again? I cannot hear. Actually, did anybody said milk? Ghee? Dairy. So the company's full name is Govind Milk and Milk Products. So friends, 2 years back, this brand was going through a crisis of creating a clear perception of this brand. Yeah? So what do you mean by creating a perception of a brand? Okay. So I will say a few keywords and aap log fatafat words bologe. Yeah? Okay, without thinking. Tata? Trust. Okay, one by one, please. Trust. I can't hear, friends. I can't hear. Please. This is important. One by one, please. Can you stand up and say? Anybody wants to say, please stand up and say that word. Tata, repeat. Tata Motors. Go ahead, next. Tata Salt, next. T. Okay, go ahead. Ek ek karke, please, khade hoke boliye. Steel, okay. Consultancy, okay. Okay. Sit down. I will repeat my question. Ratan Tata, brilliant. I was seeking that from somebody. Ratan Tata. Guys, I will repeat my question. Perception of a brand. I'm not asking you what business they are into. You can say those, but I'm asking perception of a brand. Somebody said trust. Somebody said Ratan Tata. How is this brand looked upon in this country today and across the world? Trust, Ratan, as a lineage company. Okay, yes, of course, lineage. Okay, come again. Reliable. यार तुम में से यहां कोई टाटा नैनो नाम की गाड़ी सुना है क्या जो जल गई थी और तुमने बोला रिलायबल वाओ बट फ्रेंड्स यही सच है परसेप्शन इज ट्रूथ आई डोंट नो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर हियर इंजीनियर्स और ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियर्स और अंडरस्टैंड द टाटा नैनो स्टोरी विच ऑफकोर्स I mean, there is a big story behind it where which has been admitted by Ratan Tata in his book, My Biggest Mistake, by quoting Tata Nano as the cheapest car of this country and why it is a big flop. I hope you guys know that it's a big flop. Huh? It's the biggest blunder Tatas have done, Tata Nano. And you said reliability. But friends, that's the perception of the brand. Yes, Tata is trust, Tata is reliable. टाटा डोकोमो वाले परेशान हो जाते हैं बॉस कस्टमर सर्विस नाम की चीज नहीं होती टाटा डोकोमो में बट ट्रस्ट रिलायबिलिटी एब्सोल्युटली राइट यू गाइस आर नॉट रॉन्ग सो द नेक्स्ट वर्ड आई एम थ्रोइंग एट यू इज रिलायंस रेंज वन बाय वन प्लीज Ritesh says, chor! Arre baap re. Kyun yaar, kya chori? Matlab, come on. Did somebody said growth? Nobody said growth. Kyun? You said growth. Brilliant. अरे चोर क्यों यार सो इस देश में पैसा कमाना मतलब पाप है हाँ है एंड मोदी इज राइडिंग बिग ऑन इट आई थिंक बट पाप है एवरीबॉडी लुक्स एट रिलायंस फ्रॉम दैट एंगल कल को आप लोगों को शेयर में पैसे डालने हो किसके शेयर में पैसे डालोगे टाटा के कि रिलायंस के रिलायंस 90% ऑफ टाटा कंपनीज आर इन माइनस इट्स अ रिवर्स विद रिलायंस कल को स्टॉक पे पैसा लगाना है तो रिलायंस में डालोगे और रिलायबिलिटी किसके नाम की है टाटा की वाओ फ्रेंड्स परसेप्शन दिस इज परसेप्शन एंड परसेप्शन इज ट्रूथ व्हाट आई थिंक अबाउट यू इज ट्रूथ आप वो हो या नहीं वो बात की बात है सो दिस वॉज द प्रॉब्लम विद दिस ब्रांड नाउ It's too strategic a presentation. I will quickly come to a very important slide. So, guys, any idea? Because this brand was building on a product which is called milk. Who takes a decision on milk in a household scenario? The mother. Brilliant. Achha insight. Eh? Sorry. So these are the 100 brands that we have. 100 यहाँ दिख नहीं रहे हैं, but बहुत सारे brands हैं इंडिया में. When it comes to dairy products, what is Amul's perception? Amul दूध पीता है इंडिया. Simple, right? It's a brand that is riding on India. There's a brand. अच्छा, any idea you guys would have which is the largest brand when it comes to ghee? Patanjali. Next. Did somebody say Govardhan? Brilliant. One of the most unknown brands in India. Patanjali, bahut piche. one of the most unknown brands of India and the largest ghee seller in India, Govardhan. Huge challenge with me because I'm in that premise. So Amul is in milk. Amul is not the largest ghee seller, by the way. It's Govardhan. And there are such many brands which took us by surprise when we got into research. But friends, every brand has a perception created. Any idea what is the, I mean, for the larger guys who come from northern part of India, Mother Dairy, so sorry. What is Mother Dairy for you guys? Delhi, Calcutta? Ice cream. I'm sure when you guys traveled from Delhi or Calcutta to Pune, दुकान में आके पूछा था मदर डेयरी का दूध है क्या? पूछा था? मिला? नहीं मिला. Again, extremely regional business, but then the brand has a perception in customer's mind. And we have just jotted it down. When it comes to a brand like Danone, imported, must be damn good. Amul is on India. Mother Dairy is happy food, good people. There is a local brand here called Chitle. I don't know. All Pune guys, Chitle? Trust me, ask a Puneri. Chitle se achha kuch ho hi nahi sakta. You may come from Switzerland, but boss, Chitle is the best. But that's the perception the brand holds. The challenge with me was, I did not have any perception. Silence, guys, please. Brand Govind had no perception. So, good news or bad news? Good news, absolutely good news, because I have a clean slate in front of me. I don't have to work on any perception or pre-created perception in the mind of the consumer. Mera kaam aasan tha, difficult nahi. Because there was no perception about this brand in the market. And who said that? Our research said that. So we met a lot of customers. And when you say a lot of customers, actually you meet customers. Yeah, you meet them, ask them. There are people who are loyal to this brand for the last 5 years. And you ask them, what does this brand stand for? The way when I said Tata, you guys said trust. And when I said Reliance, some other words. This brand did not carry anything in the consumer's mind. Good news for us. I don't know if you guys follow TED Talks. Great. Simon Sinek, anybody heard of? Heard of? Impressed. Okay. So Simon Sinek has a very basic question to all brands. And trust me, many brands like a Samsung and Apple, they're all getting into this premise. Guys, business houses, CEOs of companies know where they have to reach. Every CEO of company knows, 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 50 years, where we have to reach. The CEOs also know how we are going to do it. They know it in their business plan. The big question Simon Sinek is asking CEOs today is, why you want to do it, what you want to do. And this question is not connected to revenues or profits. For those of you who want to become entrepreneurs in life, money cannot be the reason of doing business. Can never be. Money is a result of conducting your business. It may happen, may not happen, but money can't be the reason of doing business. No entrepreneur in his core, until he wants to, be in that premise of banake bech dunga aur 100 crore andar and lutyens mein mera bangla. Uske alawa, largely businessmen do it for a big reason. And it is that reason that keeps driving them for years and years and years. So you can't go to a Ratan Tata and a Mukesh Ambani, sir, aap to paisa kamane dhanda karte ho. Bullshit. Money is a byproduct. This is what businessmen today are running after. This is what entrepreneurs today are running after. Why am I doing what am I doing? Forget new entrepreneurs, even the old ones. They're trying to get into the core, including the CEOs of brands like Apple, Samsung, and Nike. Why am I doing what am I doing? And this is extremely important today. This brand, Govind, and their CEO, Mr. Rajiv Mitra, was asked the same question. And trust me, friends, it's an extremely difficult question to answer. It's not easy. Very difficult. So what did we do? We went into our 8-step process, into the research process. And while we were doing that process, we realized that there is a veterinary doctor, yeah? There's a veterinary doctor in Govind who said that, you know what, we invest a lot on our farms, our cows. So just for you to understand, usually dairy companies do not have their own farms. Huh? They do not have their own cows. They operate like an Amul, like a cooperative. They would collect milk from all the farmers who have cows in that village. Then they will process that milk, and you have a cheese and a butter, milk itself coming out from there. This veterinary doctor said that, you know, there is a difference. I mean, and we were hungry. कि बस तुम्हारा जो प्रोडक्ट है तुम्हारा जो मिल्क है वो बाकी मिल्क से अलग कैसे है? अब दूध दूध है यार, दूध दूध है, अमूल का दूध और मेरे दूध में क्या फर्क है? Until somebody told me that boss, you know what, my cows who give this milk are happy cows. And I was like, what bullshit here? I have never seen a cow smiling. And our entire team didn't have a choice, friends, because that is the only insight we had. We traveled to this place called Fulton. It's a village in Satara district. Currently, Fulton has become famous because of the Cummins plant. It's the largest plant in the world. It's called the mega plant, so it's become very famous. We went to the farms to meet the cows. Stupid. And that's where the insight came from. So this veterinary doctor was busy showing us that we don't. So there is a sling, you know. काम को बात के रखते हैं. There is a time, there is a fixed time by the watch when the milking process will start. This place was different. They had let the cows free. And we were like, I mean, how do you monitor that whether the milking is happening or not? And this veterinary doctor gave us a strange statement that cow ki marzi. मैंने कहा क्या बात कर रहे हो यार? He said, हाँ. When it is happy, it comes by itself and stands in a defined area where the milking happens. I was zapped. While traveling to Switzerland, my guide had told me that Swiss cows, the whole premise of Switzerland selling milk and dairy products is our cows are happy cows. That's Switzerland statement, that we let our cows go wherever they want to, they come back, milking not an issue. And because the cows are happy, the milk is happy. I'm like, yeah, what is this? And we went deep into it. It was a very interesting insight for us, friends. Very interesting insight. We went deep into it, and it became our biggest differentiator. And I thought that in hazaro brands mein se, if I say that my milk is a happy milk, maybe it's stupidity, but will it attract a few customers? Then what the hell is a happy milk? And that's exactly what we did with the brand. Now, coming back, when I was in this model, we realized that the owner of this brand is a king. His family has been the king of Fulton, and they have been working a lot towards the villagers and the farmers, and thus this brand Govind was discovered. So this guy was, what he was doing was practicing conscious, inclusive progress. I'll repeat the word. Conscious, it means I want to do it. Inclusive, me and all of you together will grow. And progress is progress. So he was making sure that all the farms, all the villagers, all the people who had all the cows was taken care of by him, by his veterinary doctor. And this was his way of doing business. When we met Mr. Nimbalkar, Mr. Nayak Nimbalkar, when he met him, he said, Rajat, paisa to banega yaar, paisa to byproduct hai. Lekin mere forefathers is province ke kings rahe hain. We have been protecting the villagers. Today it is my moral duty to make sure that along with me, these guys also progress. Inke ghar mein cycle thi, aaj ek sumo aa gayi hai. Have they progressed? Yes. And that is my objective of doing business with them. And when this is your objective, you will always take care of your people. You will always take care of people. Friends, all of you who know the little model of cooperative movement, Amul is an icon of that. It's very similar. Aap aur aapke saath aapke sare log, jo aapke vendors hain, suppliers hain, सब मिलके प्रोग्रेस कर रहे हैं एंड दैट इज हिज वाई ऑफ द बिजनेस एंड दिस वाई विल नेवर चेंज हिज एवरी स्टेप हिज एवरी बिजनेस मूव विल बी ओरिएंटेड टुवर्ड्स दैट व्हाइल आई ग्रो विल माई फार्मर्स ग्रो विथ मी विल दीज गाइज ग्रो विथ मी एंड ही इज अ सुपर बिजनेसमैन ही नोज दैट कल अगर ये रॉ मटेरियल व्हाट इज द रॉ मटेरियल ऑफ डेयरी प्रोडक्ट्स मिल्क If tomorrow this milk is stopped, the supply of the milk is stopped, my business is shut. And he's taking care of not only of the cows, he's taking care of that farmer who owns the cows. He's taking care of him emotionally. Those guys will never ever give their milk to any other competitor in that area. And you guys have recently joined, you would know what kind of competition is developing in Satara and Kolhapur. Friends, there are more than 50 dairy brands in this area. For information, Maharashtra is also the highest milk producing state in the country. The competition is huge. And this guy here, the MD of the company, Mr. Nimbalkar, is taking care of his supplier. His suppliers will never go anywhere else. So, I'll come to the creative, which we made for them. I don't know whether you will be able to see it. So this was the premise, guys, which we proposed. So of course, what happens in advertising, a kind of creative goes to the client. It's revised, and finally, we get the revised creative. This was the premise that we made. So what is Govind? Happy maker, simple. So people come and ask me, sir, kya banate ho aap? Doodh, ghee, chhach, paneer, ice cream. What do you make? I make happy. As if happy was a product. I make happy. And everything, all communication from that day till now that has been happening has been around this premise of happy. I am the happy maker. Any idea, guys? In a household situation, who's the happy maker? Mom. Wow. Am I talking to the audience? Am I talking to the right audience? Mom is my audience. The mother is my audience. She is the happy maker of the family. She is also the decision maker as to what brand of milk will come into my house. So when I arrive at a premise, it must do multiple things. It will surprise my customers. What do you mean by making happy? It must talk to my right audience and excite that audience that, you know, I am the brand for you. I connect with you. So I'll just skip this. I'll take you through the creative that finally happened. And I will show you a TVC on Govind. So this was, sorry. Did I miss it? So these are the final creators that went out, which said, make something you haven't made before. Make happy. Make that restaurant special your special. Make happy. I'm selling paneer. Friends, another challenge here was, while I was working on this campaign, the entire team was working on this campaign, Govind as a brand was evolving from milk to different products. I had to also make sure that all products that we have, and I'm going to expand into an ice cream and many other products, what I state today must hold true in the future. As the company expands, there should not be a need to change the statement, the happy makers. Make mithai even sweeter, make happy. Okay.
Kya hua?
Mujhe na enjoy karna hi pasand. I'm not happy.
Okay. So let's make happy. Happiness can't be made. Govind, the happy makers.
And I just want Before this Mr. Rajiv Mitra, he wants to, happy makers, he wanted to be here.
Govind as a brand did not have a in the consumer's mind, nor did we reflect any particular promise. before we came to be known as Happy Makers, Govind as a brand did not have a clear perception in the consumer's mind, nor did we reflect any particular promise. This was precisely the brief to Paradigm Plus. The need was to create a lasting impression about the brand. Paradigm Plus did an extremely good job at it. They showcased the journey from happy cows right up to happy consumers. Happy makers is an all-encompassing thought that can take even the future products under its wings. Milk producers, processors, channel partners, all without exception became happy makers, and it was a positive wave of thought all across. Most importantly, the consumer started looking at us in a newfound positive way. I hope that we continue this journey of being happy makers. Well done, Rajat Sarkar and Team Paradigm Plus. Thank you very much. Sir.
Thanks, friends. This was the last case that I had to present you today. It's already time. Friends, did you guys understand the process? Next time, when you see an ad in print, on television, try to explore what must have gone behind the ad. I've already discussed iPhone with you guys, already discussed Bajaj, Hero Honda. Every ad that you guys see has got a huge business objective. All of you who are interested in this field in the future must look at what went behind. Yeah? I'm open for any questions. Otherwise, I'm done. Give the mic to him.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
My name is Suyesh Jain, and I come from Raipur city, Chhattisgarh. And there, due to overcrowding of this passenger autos, the RTO has stopped the registration of tempo autos. So how can the ape are dealing, or how as a being
ape
truck, ape auto autos, are you dealing?
No, I didn't get your question.
Actually, the RTO has stopped the registration of passenger autos due to overcrowding in the city.
Okay.
So how being an advertising company, how can you advertise over there?
How can I advertise over there?
Yes, sir.
You can take this. Yeah.
See, normally what happens is, whenever it's all about passenger vehicles, you know, there's a certain process involved in selling a vehicle. Normally nobody, like we go and buy a car or a bike, would go and pick up a passenger vehicle, because you need a, what do you say, permit. And without the permit, no vehicle is sold. And what happens is, in the business, in our country, there's a lot of clout when it comes to getting a permit. And that clout exists for many other brands. Like Bajaj is a leader in passenger vehicles in the country when it comes to three-wheelers. But when it comes to Piaggio, or Ape rather, you know, there's a different clout. And when a government is saying that you cannot sell passenger vehicles, advertising cannot help. Because there's a norm, there's a rule that the government has set. Even if you advertise, it's not going to make a difference. Nobody's going to buy the product. So it's going to be actual waste of money for the client, and you'd rather utilize that money somewhere else where it will make sense.
Maybe I'll have to go to tier 3 markets and sell it.
Yeah.
I don't have a choice, because my numbers have to come from any part of India.
Hello, sir. At the back, middle section.
Right. Yeah.
Sir, my name is Prachi, and my question is, how are the initial advertisement campaign designed to draw more and more prospective customer to a new company?
How?
How are the initial advertisement campaign designed to draw more and more prospective customer to a new company?
What do you mean by initial?
So when the company is starting. So yeah. How
so do at the launch stage of a brand.
Yeah.
So, see, usually, I mean, I'll have to go a little deep. Your name is Sakshi?
Prachi.
Prachi. Hi, Prachi. So, Prachi, it's very important to understand where your consumer is. So let's say if it was a new truck, I will go and start talking to the fleet owners, yeah, because they are my consumers. If it's a washing powder, I will go out and go masses. I'll have to do print and television, and I'll have to go masses because every lady in this country becomes my consumer. Yeah, but usually what brands do is they identify their target audience and which markets they would like to attack first. For example, if tomorrow, I don't know, aap logo ne ye ad dekha tha kya? Vim ka ek ad tha for rural India, which had talked about, it had compared how Vim performs against koila, because in some research they showed that in villages, the ladies clean their utensils with ash, right? So if for that kind of a market I'm launching a product, I will go to the villages, tier three places, and talk. But usually what brands do is they would largely target a state or a part of the state, and once they are done, they succeed, they take their learnings from there, then they will go to the other markets. So I repeat, if your customer is extremely niche, let's say I'm launching a new truck, I will go to only the truck drivers, I will go only to the fleet owners. If I'm launching a mass product, I will go to the masses.
Yeah. Good evening, sir.
Hi.
Very good evening, sir. My name is Karanveer.
Hi, Karan.
I wanted to ask a very small question.
Be a little loud.
I wanted to ask a very small question. Like, since you do a market survey for for ad campaigns and all, so do you have a specific team in your company for market survey, or do you depend on outsourced marketing surveys or?
Yeah. So if it is what we call as a dipstick survey, if it's a dipstick survey, we would do it. So dipstick survey is anywhere. What, between 100 customers to 200 customers, Ritesh?
Dipstick survey would be within your local market where your agencies are present. Say if we have offices in Pune, Bangalore, we would do it within those regions. Like if there are other national agencies who would have it in all the four metros, they would do it in their market. But when it comes to real large-scale research, then there are specific market agencies, research agencies. Who would do the research. Yeah.
So in that case, the agency would get involved in making and developing the questionnaire. Yeah, a very important part of the market research activity will be involved in the development of the questionnaire. And of course, as the results start pouring in, we'll be involved in seeing what the results are. So very good question, Karamveer. The Govind case that I showed you, there was a third party market research agency that was involved, which did the entire market research activity across Pune and other markets. And they gave us the results.
Hello, sir.
Good evening, sir. Balcony.
Ladies first. Sorry.
Okay. Yeah.
Sir, I have a question. These brands, you have made ads for brands like Govind. So, what was your approach in the initial period when your company was a startup? How did you convince them?
When I was a startup.
Yeah, when the company.
Govind.
The company Paradigm.
I am 18 year old. Your name?
Ankita.
So Ankita, we are 18 year old. So Govind is with us for the last 2 years.
Okay. So okay, sir.
You're talking about how a young agency
companies?
Pitches.
What about the other companies? The other brands? How did you approach them to make ads for them?
So Ankita, usually what happens is brands call for multi-agency pitches. Yeah, the pitch is thrown open in the market. We come to know through our sources. And you would see 5, 7, 10 agencies going and making their credential presentations. There is a brief given by the client to all the agencies. We work on the brief, we come back, and whoever is most befitting, I'm using the word befitting, to the business objective of the client is who's on board.
Okay. Good evening, sir. I'm Nikita.
Hi.
Roy.
Hi, Nikita.
Sir, I have a question. If you want to approach a big brand name company, what is your procedure or plan of action? As in, you want to...
What is a big brand name company?
As in, any company whose assignment you want to take to advertise their company. And from their paradigm is gaining any high revenue. So what is your plan of action to... Take over that assignment.
Understand their business objective or marketing challenge first. If you understand their marketing challenge with clarity, with extreme clarity, I'm sure the creative that you will make will address their issue and you can come on board.
Okay. Hello, sir.
Hello, sir.
There is one guy here who has been, just 2 minutes. Yeah, tell me.
Sir, my name is Rishi.
Hi, Rishi.
And my question is, how do you measure the effectiveness of a particular ad campaign?
Well, what happens is, the very immediate measurement that you come to know is either through sales or the numbers changing, which you immediately know through your production or the sales figures that go up. Otherwise, to gauge the effectiveness of any ad campaign, be it print, television, radio, you do a research, which is called a post-campaign research, to understand the effectiveness. It's a measurement matrix through which we assign research agencies who do the research across the country or depending on a geography that you assign, and basis which we come up with the data that shows us as to how effective the campaign has
been. Hello,
sir.
Yes. Over here.
Yes.
Sir, my name is Harshil.
Hi, Harshil.
And I have a question. Television advertisement has been considered to be expensive. So, has the television advertising industry affected with the increase in social media advertisement?
Well,
if yes, then what factors do they take to cope up with the competition?
I didn't get your name, sorry. Harshit.
Harshil. Yes.
Okay. See, what happens is, when it comes to advertising, you know, there are specific brands, there are specific products that are moving away from television now. If you look at the trend, now why do you see so much of activity in digital, in social media? Because the younger generation today is always on their mobiles and tablets and computer screens, right? So even if the television spots are expensive, there are some brands who will not go away from it because television still is the largest medium to advertise because it reaches out to the maximum number of people in one go. While it is expensive, you know, it all depends on what is your core focus of doing that advertisement. Is it just brand building? Is it launching a new product? Is it making people aware of your new schemes or promotions or what? It all depends. Basis the objective is the medium you choose. Nowadays, the times have gone when people would think of planning to advertise and they would think only television as a medium.
Also to add
sir,
to
hi,
what
sir.
Pritesh
sir,
said.
Sorry, you're up in the balcony.
Two minutes.
Sir.
2 minutes.
Sir, now my name is Mohammed Hafiz. We'll
2 minutes. 2 minutes, Mohammed. Harshil, also to add to what Ritesh said, realize that there is nothing in this world, as far as advertising is concerned or media is concerned, there is nothing that is expensive and cheap. I have been telling this to my clients also. Kuch nahi hota aisa, expensive. Television is expensive because 10 seconds of Star Plus is costing you maybe 10 lakh rupees. And the 10 seconds on your phone is costing you nothing, right? Please realize when media companies, ad agencies and brands decide to advertise on television and pay that 10 lakh rupees for the 30 seconds, they know whom they're talking to. They know whom they're talking to. So a brand like Go With Milk, who is my client, I will get less response from digital as compared to television. Because I have to talk to the lady of the house who is watching a serial, TV serial in the evening or in the afternoon. I have to talk to her. I have to be on television. So it's always, there is an effectiveness matrix that is developed. So it's all about what kind of revenues, what kind of returns you are getting from which media. There is no, even if I put 1 crore rupees on digital medium for a brand like Govin, it will be of no use to me, even if it is cheaper.
Sir, yes, can I ask?
Now we Hello, have sir. Our last question for
sir. Okay.
Good evening, sir.
Sir, how can we advertise an advertisement?
Last question.
Sir.
Sir, here, balcony.
Mohammed, Eid Mubarak.
Sir,
bolo,
sir
on your right. Thank you. On your right, sir.
Sir.
Oh, yeah. Sir.
Sir.
Achha,
so
do le
on your right.
Okay, two. Mohammed first because he asked it and then you.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, go ahead, Mohammed.
Sir, how can we advertise an advertisement?
How can we advertise?
An advertisement.
An advertisement?
Yes, sir.
I'm doing it right now. मैं वही तो कर रहा हूँ। I'm advertising my advertisement.
सर आप नहीं आते तो?
मैं नहीं आता तो कोई और आता भाई।
I'll tell you how do you advertise an advertisement. in your everyday language or discussion within your friends or, you know, whomsoever, how many times do you say a word or a line which either relates to a movie, a film, or an ad? Do y'all or don't y'all? So that is an advertisement of an advertisement. Okay.
This would be our last question.
This will be the last question. Yeah, go ahead.
So, sir, my name is Namrata, and my question is, so you talk about perception, that perception is the truth and it's the growth as well. So,
and it's growth as well.
Yeah, you said that perception is the truth.
Yeah, not okay. Growth.
Okay. So, apart from perception, what strategies do you use that engages the customers?
What strategies we use?
Yes, apart from perception, like the one-liners which you create.
Perception is not a strategy. Okay. Perception is a strategy. What, how I engage with a consumer, the result of that is perception. Okay. How I engage with a consumer. Look at the way Tatas are engaging with this nation, right?
Yes, sir.
They are ethical, they are this, they are trust, they stand for trust. So what the way Ratan Tata conducts himself, or any Tata brand conducts itself, is the perception they are creating. So I don't, perception is not a way to engage. Perception is a result. So I will engage with the consumer in a manner, keeping in mind what perception I want to draw. So, I showed you the example of Govind. So yes. Govind will engage with all its consumer in a manner such that the perception of the brand will always be in the premise of happy. I'm the happy maker. I cannot do anything in this country or in my market or with my consumers which will make them unhappy. Thanks, guys. You've been a fantastic audience.
Good evening, everyone. It's my privilege to prepare a vote of thanks on this occasion. I, student manager Roshni, on behalf of entire fraternity of Sri Balaji Society, extend a very hearty thanks to respected sir for gracing this occasion. Today, we learned that good advertising does not just circulate information. It penetrates the public with mind, desires, and belief. I wish to express our profound thanks to Bala sir for organizing such guest lectures and encouraging us to do better. I hope we are all able to apply these learnings in our life. Thank you, sir. Thank you.